We have Ferrazzi, who is a Gentoo Linux developer and the leader of the Gentoo Kernel project and a member of the Gentoo Foundation board, and is working at Cybertrust Japan as an embedded software engineer. She'll be presenting on GKernelCI version 2, its new features, and KernelCI compatibility. Please welcome Alice.
Thank you. In this presentation, I will talk about Gentoo KernelCI, about new feature and KernelCI compatibility. As already been presented, I will skip my presentation. I'm part of Gentoo and part of Cybertrust Japan, as I said before. In this presentation, I will talk about advanced Gentoo Kernel project. I will talk a bit about Gentoo KernelCI. And in the end, I will talk about the collaboration that we are doing with KernelCI. Kcidb, and at the end I will talk about what we want to do next and the conclusion. So I will talk in really short about what the Gentoo Kernel project is doing and only the part that is interesting to Gentoo KernelCI. And so we are practically doing Gentoo source that is practically a Linux kernel with some Gentoo specific patch, but there are really few patch. I hear that some distribution is using like more than 400 patch. We are less than 10 patch in Gentoo source, and that are specific to Gentoo. And we also have other Gentoo kernel source flavor. We are compiling and booting such Gentoo source. And if everything is working, we are stabilizing the Gentoo source package in Gentoo. So in 2006, end of 2006, we see that we was doing some part that was always same, and we thought we could make a more efficient process and automate some part of what we was doing. And that is how Gentoo KernelCI started. So this is Gentoo KernelCI and is the new version, because the old version I don't have screenshot anymore. In 2008 there was the Spectre meltdown problem, and Upstream asked to double check some of the release. So we was one of I think one of the first to start to automate send email to Upstream about success of Upstream and double checking that Upstream was booting correctly and doing some tests. So what is changing from Gentoo KernelCI version 1 to Gentoo KernelCI version 2? We have at first we started to do mostly from scratch, and we made like script for booting QEMU and many dependent script for the machine. And recently we decided to move everything to Docker and make it more simple, and also more simple to add more tests. So we use currently Lava. And what is happening recently is KernelCI, that is recently became part of Linux Foundation, is it made a tool called Kcidb, and we start to integrate such tool with the Gentoo KernelCI process. So current Gentoo KernelCI infrastructure is we have a server for Lava and a server for practically the buildbot part and some script. We are checking the Gentoo source repository if there is any new patch. We will get the rootfs from we would like to build actually rootfs in our infrastructure, but currently we don't have a resource. So we are getting rootfs from some Gentoo mirror, and then we are building the kernel. We will put everything to a file server, and we will send everything to Lava that we will check. We will do QEMU testing. And if everything will goes well, we will have a notification to KernelCI and to Gentoo KernelCI. So the feature about Gentoo KernelCI is that mainly is tailored for what we are doing the Gentoo Kernel project. So it is tailored for the Gentoo Kernel process that we are using for releasing the Linux kernel with patch from Gentoo to the to releasing such package. But we would like, but can be used also for testing other flavor or other kernel, because it's mainly just based on buildbot. And we try to make it really simple to use. So we are keeping everything in Docker, and this can be started in one line. Actually, someone say that also Gentoo can be installed in one line, but I think it's more simple than that. And we have a few languages which we mainly use just Python and Bash. Is highly customizable because it's based on buildbot and Lava. And recently we using Kcidb for pushing result to KernelCI. So Kcidb is a KernelCI project. Is try to unify different CI system in the KernelCI, because currently we have many different KernelCI and each one is sending his own his own result to upstream. Is also have different way of making such a report, and KernelCI is trying to make a same way for each CI to have same structure of the report that we are sending, and then sending the notification to upstream. So, but for sending the notification to KernelCI, we need the KernelCI access credential. We at first get the testing credential of Kcidb, that it was uploaded to a test environment. And actually yesterday we got the production, and so we can actually start to send our result to upstream KernelCI. But we still didn't try. It will be in the next day. It will be the next things that we will do. And the report that is using KernelCI for sending everything upstream is using JSON. So practically, this is one of the reports that Gentoo KernelCI is using for sending to Kcidb, that Kcidb it will send to KernelCI. And we have a version that is, I think, is the JSON version. We have a revision, build, and some test results. Here I'm also showing the revision and the build. We have a validation type for saying if the in the revision is saying practically if the patch are actually merged correctly. I am skipping many patch from, not so many, but some patch I'm skipping. And this distro Gentoo kconf is one of the few patch that is adding Gentoo for to the kernel that is using. And we have an idea, origin, the discovery time for checking when it was built. And the now one of the things that it was bit different from what we was doing, actually Gentoo KernelCI is producing some output, so we have to change such output for upstream kernel for using Kcidb. And one of that is was asking is the revision ID, that is actually the Linux kernel base that we are using, the commit hash of that Linux base, with some Gentoo patch and some other the Gentoo source that is using as patch as such hash, and combining such two information for getting the revision ID that we are sending to by Kcidb. So for sending this data, we are using Kcidb submit, and we are sending in the Kcidb production version of Kcidb with some data file that is Gentoo KernelCI is producing about the result. And this one is the Kcidb frontend, where Kcidb is containing is particularly is using Grafana for showing the data that it has in the database. And these are the recent build that Gentoo KernelCI is starting to send to the testing system of Kcidb. So what Gentoo KernelCI what to do next? Currently we are practically just doing some kernel tests, but and this is helping a bit on the Gentoo kernel process, but we want to go a bit more fast about. And we want to implement more tests, and by this improving the Gentoo kernel testing and process. And also adding more customization, so also trying to don't build only Gentoo source, but also some other flavor that we have in Gentoo. We have like also vanilla source that is practically just Linux kernel, and that was one of the reason that upstream they wanted some of our build, is because our the package that we are releasing is practically almost same as upstream. And here we can see the these the architecture that Gentoo is supporting, and what currently we are just stabilizing for x86-64, but we want also to try to stabilize automatically at least ARM and some other architecture. So in conclusion, Gentoo KernelCI project is trying to helping kernel upstream by collaborating with KernelCI using Kcidb. We try to improve the Gentoo kernel source process in by automatizing some part of the Gentoo process. And we try to improve also Gentoo kernel testing by try to also by sending everything to KernelCI, but also by trying to build also different flavor from Gentoo source. And also in the future we would also like to give a possibility to the user to use Gentoo KernelCI for sending patch or such thing. And I think that I went a bit more fast than I thought. So we probably have some time for question if there is any question. And practically if you have interested about Gentoo KernelCI, we have you can see Gentoo KernelCI in action. It is different from the one that there is in the abstract about Gentoo KernelCI, because the one that there is in the abstract is supported by a user, Gentoo user, and but recently we got a resource from Gentoo infrastructure to have our built-in environment for Gentoo KernelCI. And I leave the project repository and the support channel on Freenode. That's all for me. If there is
Okay, so we do have a few minutes for questions. If you wish to post a question, just post it in the Tux Theatre stream chat. And I've also copied in there the URLs that are on this slide. So if you want to go take a look, go click on those.
So if there is no question, well, the point is what I'm saying in the presentation is particularly that we are recently collaborating with Kcidb, and so every result is sent to KernelCI. Also some other continuous integration systems that are doing some tests on kernel are recently starting to use Kcidb and collaborating with KernelCI. So KernelCI is currently in CI system.
So we've got some questions. So firstly, are you looking to check against specific hardware in this CI system?
Okay. At first, we are thinking to use that to mainly virtualize everything, but someone talked us about using some real hardware in the future. And we are checking specific hardware that is interesting to Gentoo. So what Gentoo is trying to stabilize is what I showed in the here. So these are the architecture that Gentoo is trying to stabilize. I don't think if we can stabilize everything, but we will try to stabilize at least most of what Gentoo is declaring a stable architecture. And the benefit of using Lava for QEMU bot. Yes, at first we started to do to use QEMU everything by scratch. We had some script for doing all such tests. But the problem is it became like when we have to catch some problem, or we have to script also like when you do some test, you have to catch the result of the test. And Lava is a bit more some kind of standardized, if I can use such word. It has some is more reliable than trying to do everything by hand from what I could see. So in our case, using Lava could help us doing better testing for the Gentoo source, not only just boot test, but also in the future, like using Kcidb test or some other kernel related test.
Okay, that looks to be all the questions that we have. If you think of any more questions, head on over to the Kernel Miniconf Boff channel in Venulus and keep the discussion going over there. Thank you very much, Alice.
Thank you, and I hope that everyone enjoy the rest of the conference.
We'll now take a... 10-